Libero SoC version 12.2 has now been released. In this video, we will highlight the new features and enhancements that are included in this update. The Libero SoC version 12.2 was released on September 24, 2019. This release offers a few new devices in the PolarFire and RTG4 families. In the PolarFire family, we are supporting production timing and power for all PolarFire devices with a core voltage of 1.05 volts. In addition, we are supporting production timing and power for MPF500T S&TS devices with a core voltage of 1 volt. With the release of Libero SoC version 12.2, we now support production data for simultaneous switching noise, or SSN, for all the PolarFire devices. In the RTG4 family, we are supporting production timing for 150K logic element devices with CQFP352 package in standard and -1 speed grades. We are also supporting production timing for the low-power version of RTG4 150K logic element devices with CQFP352 package in standard speed grade. Compared to version 12.1, Microchip improved timing analysis runtime by up to 20% for PolarFire devices. Additionally, runtime is improved in place and route by 20% for larger designs of RTG4, Smart Fusion 2, and Igloo 2 families. This release also improved simulation runtime by 20%. Place and route performance has also been increased. In regular effort place and route, design performance improved by up to 8% and up to 5% in high effort place and route. This release moves the PolarFire transceiver into production status with some enhancements. For the first time, half duplex options are enabled with PolarFire transceiver in PMA and 8B10B modes. With this enhancement, TX-only mode, RX-only mode, and TX and RX independent mode are supported using the new transceiver configurator. All three of these new modes are supported in simulation and smart debug tools. The PolarFire PCIe configurator in 1X mode has enhanced by removing additional unused TX and RX ports. Transceiver power will be reduced. Version 12.2 also supports production status for IOD CDR. The PolarFire IOD CDR is enhanced to support simple DDR and SDR modes. Dynamic delay line control for this core has been added. Manual I/O register combining is introduced with this release, as well as LVDS fail-safe mode in all the IOD configurators. This option enables you to control ODT. Typically, we keep ODT off at POR and keep it on after the inputs are essentially driven. We are now supporting production status for PolarFire CCC with a few enhancements, including external and post-VCO feedback modes. With the production CCC core, we simplified the power jitter options to have just two options: maximize VCO for lowest jitter and minimize VCO for lowest power. This core also shows the VCO value as a feedback in the configurator. The expose power down port feature is enabled by default for all feedback modes. Here are the other PolarFire and RTG4 silicon features. System services core, apart from transceiver CCC and IOD CDR, are in production status. Manual I/O register combining using PDC is supported with this release. The large SRAM is now configured with ECC using design initialization data and memory's configuration. With reference to the RTG4, we added two additional features, including AHB Lite and AXI4 interfaces for SRAM, using the new RTG4 SRAM core. And we are now generating configuration reports for SerDes, FDDR, and CCCs. There have also been some language enhancements with Libero SoC version 12.2, including VHDL context file. This is used to define a list of libraries and packages in a single context file. In previous releases, the default HDL language is Verilog language. In this update, the default language is System Verilog. Based on customer feedback, there are new TCI commands for smart design and IP cores. Improvements to the text editor have also been made by adding multiple options that are supported by any modern text editor. There are a couple of major licensing enhancements with the Libro SoC version 12.2 release. We've added the MPF300T 1FCG484E device to a gold license to support the new PolarFire Splash Kit. Based on additional customer feedback, we've introduced License Selection UI that enables a user to select the required license before invoking Libro. If the license is expiring in 15 days or earlier, the UI displays a warning message. This will help the user to place a renewal order before the expiration of the license. Version 12.2 also supports programming and debug tools using Flash Pro 6. With the Flash Pro 6 programmer, we improved the programming time compared to the older versions of Flash Pro. For even more details on all the available features, please refer to the link in the description of this video for the Libro SoC version 12.2 release notes. Thanks for watching!